Let me try to get back to the agenda here. Thank you for your comments. Let me see the track project in Lobato Trestle. John, here we are.
Well, one thing with the track project, actually, most of the stuff we talked about sort of doom and gloom, but the track project, we still did pretty well, even though we had a lot of detours and everything with the trestle, I mean, up to this point. We've installed 8,237 ties this year. I mean, our goal was 12,000. We won't make that goal because of what we're doing with the dollars and stuff like that, but it's still a good year. That's
what was the number installed?
8,237 so far this year. And we've installed 45,286 since the track project started in 2006.
54,000?
45,286. And we've surfaced 20.59 miles this year. Then we've got 125 miles surfaced since the project started. The whole railroad's been surfaced one time, and about a third of it by the end of the year will be surfaced a second time. So that's a good story. We've dumped 6,268 ton of rock so far this year. We have about 1,300 ton left on the ground at Antonito that we're dumping. And we're going to, as Marvin said, we're moving the crusher to Ozier to start crushing our own rock, and we're hoping to crush 5,000 ton there this fall. We've also spread 68,408 ton of rock scattered on the railroad so far since 2006. September 6th, we had two track projects, or funding for two track projects this year. We had $1 million from Colorado from ERA money, from stimulus money, and that's what we've been working on this summer. And then we had $400,000 from New Mexico. And the 1st of September, actually September 6th, we took the track crew off this ERA money, moved them back to the New Mexico money. It actually saved about 33%, you know, on labor, and changed our program a little bit so that we got started getting ready for winter, so we're more ready for spring when you go to open up. And then by doing this, we're going to save about $580K out of them two projects, which can be moved towards the trestle. And I think the commission's made application to transfer that money from the track project to the trestle project if needed. Other than that, is there any questions on the track project? The track gang will work till the end of the season. Normally we work till the weather shuts us down. This year we're going to work till the end of the train running, and then we'll go home. So, yeah.
But just to clarify, the track work being done now till the end of the season is really work that needs to be done to get it ready for the winter so that it's in better shape when we open next year?
Yes. Well, the main thing we're doing is where we put a lot of the ties, the reason we're making the ballast, we got that track sitting right up on top of the ground. We raised it ahead of the ties and put the ties in so we have no ballast there. Say spring, you get a lot of weather, a lot of water, that track's going to sink. You're going to be slowed way down, you know, to get over the railroad if you do get the trestle open. So what we're trying to do is pull the spots we were going to work on anyway, but we're trying to maneuver and go to the worst spots to get that up in shape. And then to help us for the spring. We're still installing ties. Just our production's down because we're sort of moving around a little bit rather than going out of phase like we were. So, you know, our production's dropped some. but...
I'm sorry.
The other thing we're doing is we've cleaned the ties up because we do clean them up afterwards and put them in piles, but if we leave them out there, then we got to plow snow. First instance, we do have to clean snow. We don't want them in our way and stuff, so...
And as a, just a follow-up question, the track between Chama and Cumbres didn't get much use this year. Does that create any kind of problem to it, just sitting there? I mean, is it better for it to be used, or is it... I don't know. I hadn't thought about it until just now.
Well, that's sort of sixes, you know. I mean, it doesn't really hurt it to sit there. Now, we have been inspecting it, at least down to the trestle and then up from Chama. I've been making a trip at least once a month down through there in case we had a rock slide or, you know, on the mainline days. I remember closing railroads for 6 months and come back, somebody stole 2-3 rails. So you want to keep going down and checking to make sure stuff's...
So we are checking.
Yeah. We have been probably more than a couple times a month, you know, between us. The track down there is actually was in the best shape of any of the track we had, because that's the last place we surfaced last fall. You know, we did all that work from Cresco to the top of the mountain at the close of the season. In fact, some of it was after the close of the season last year. So the track itself is in good condition down that way.
I just want to thank you, John, for the great job you've done with this project. Not just this year, but since its very beginning. And I also want to thank you for helping us figure out how to find $580,000 out of that project that could go toward the trestle. I think that's a very critical component.
Well, you're here. Well,
thanks, huh?
Go ahead, you got more?
Just on the trestle. Do we talk about that or just go sit down?
Let me just make this point. I want to pile on with Randy here. When we had the town meetings with Chama, we were talking about the fact that we had raised $510,000 for $1.8 to $2 million project. And I know you guys have been working on this really hard. So now with the $580,000 that's available to us through this project, we now have $1 million. Towards that trestle, and that really is significant. The management team has done a good job of pulling that money and making it available for this project. That is a priority. So is the track. We understand that, but I think we're just dealing with the priorities as they come now. So I very much appreciate getting us over $1 million towards that project.
Well, I don't get all the credit for that money. You know, there's a lot of people involved in making the decision how we went about that, you know, between Leo and everything else. So
now the management team, I think, did a good job. I appreciate that.
So I mean, it was a joint effort.
And Leo too. Okay, yeah. Thank Leo too. Go ahead.
He was shocked when I wanted it. Anyway, the trestle. Everybody's talked about the trestle, and it burned down on the 23rd of June, and the evening after the meeting, and we thought everything was going pretty good that day, and that started our troubles. It's caused a lot of problems. Just as a quick overview, we had an engineering company out by that Sunday to inspect the bridge, and their report came back that they wanted to replace the bridge. They didn't want to repair it. They wouldn't put their signature on it, you know, without replacing it. And that was about $4 million. So the management company and the commission went back out. We got we sent a letter out to ask engineering companies to make a proposal. And we had four that made a proposal, and we went through, and out of the four, we picked HDR. And they came back out first part of, I think it was August the 3rd, and did their inspection. We took two coupons out of the girder. And we actually took the coupons out of the girder that wasn't burnt, because we could get to it without getting out on the bridge.